Well, time now for the men's final as we head down to the water with our man on the dark side, Matt Crowhurst.
There we have it, a dockful, a lineup of the very best guy riders in the world when it comes to cable wakeboarding, and we have the 40th ever World Cup final taking place at Sunyi Olympic Park, perhaps the perfect setting to showcase this sport to any of those Olympic bigwigs who are watching. We should be in the Olympics, and this is exactly why. Freddie von Osten, one of the biggest names in guys cable riding, starting things off. Big old transfer on the toe side edge, rotating all the way through, back lip on to the flat bar all the way to the end, and then a back 270 out, popping it around to right foot forward. It is a huge back roll with a snailfish grab, getting that backside three on, making it a snailfish KGB. Comes in the inside the cable, just the one trick between those last two corners, and it is a massive 315, a Rayleigh with a frontside 540 on. Then he goes Esmo, then he comes out of the corner with a bit of an applause from Nick Davies, the UK rider who will be following him. Huge roll to revert into the corner, sorry, roll to blind into the corner. Has he got enough time to get to that right-hand kicker? Yes, he has, using all of the course perfectly. That is a 720, a little bit of pre-spin on that, which the judges will take note, but still super clean, and then the toe side 720 off the back of that. Now, what I mean by pre-spin is when the board starts to rotate before the rider actually gets up into the air, but either way, that has set the bar very high for the rest of our riders to follow. And the aforementioned Nick Davies, a former world champion, no stranger to the big occasion, no stranger to some absolute huge arsenal of tricks he has got. So a backside three over the transfer, then a front board onto the tail, and then rotating around to end up right foot forward seamlessly into an S to blind with a late indie grab on as well. Beautiful corner trick. Coming into the corner now, straight after that S to blind is a back mob. Now on his toe side edge, it is a scarecrow mob, one of the more difficult tricks on the cable, getting some appreciation from his fellow UK rider Declan Clifford, who will be riding shortly. Then a late grab on that roll to blind, moves it back across the cable. It is a toe side backside 540, and very uncharacteristic of Davies to fall on that. That is a day in, day out trick for him, losing the handle on the second handle pass, and he passes over to his fellow Brit, Declan Clifford. Deku also finding himself on a podium at many of the world's major events. Backside spin over that transition, 180 on, then a full 360 off. Coming back to the corner, it is the Crow Mob. We saw that from Davies a little while after in his run. Deck choosing to throw it in a little earlier. Then it is back mode 5, a 540 instead of the 360 from Deck, already dropping the hammers. Then a 313. Straight out of that corner, using all his momentum and getting some massive height because of it. It is a KGB with a little look back to the dock, then a grab on that Moby Dick, a backflip with a full backside 360, then a toe side backside 540, and that is an amazing run from Deck. So Declan Clifford of the UK taking the game to Freddie von Osten and to Nick Davies with a killer run. But what can this next rider come up with? It is Sebastian Dunn of Australia, a relatively new name to the wider world of cable wakeboarding, but looking at those first feature hits, he is no stranger to dropping bangers. Coming in with some great first two feature hits, then a big old Batmo 5 into corner number 3. He just plays it cool, coming around to the drive tower, corner number 4, and that is why it is a 315, a Rayleigh with a frontside 540 on. Huge air into that roll to blind, looking so cool, calm and collected as he moves into this other spin. It's a 900 off his heel side edge, the more difficult way of throwing a 9. Then left foot forward, backside, 900, back-to-back 9s from Sebastian Dunn. And his fellow Australian compadre there, rather happy with that performance. Over to Hungary, Sebastian Zola, transfer, back 3, and a popping of the handle. Frustration in abundance, I'm sure, for Sebastian there. Once again, though, just to reiterate, each of our riders, they get two runs. It is their best run that counts. But Sebastian piling the pressure on himself. Move over to the Dane, Andreas Kjergaard, easily one of the best riders from Denmark, on the nose press. Then popping out a frontside rotation and seemingly getting hooked up as he tries to rotate the board back underneath him. Not sure what happened there, and I'm sure that Andreas doesn't really know exactly what happened there, because I'm sure that's going to be a relatively easy trick that he would knock in day out, day out. And you can't afford to make those mistakes when you have such talent following you. Dominic Gers qualifying in second place, and he's going to be followed by San Im, rounding off this full 8-man final. Dominic having some killer runs in contest this year, taking away the rather prestigious title of Red Bull Rising High Champ earlier on in the year, that incredible event. Now he's setting his sights on an IWWF World Cup top place finish, and he can possibly do it with big tricks like that. It was the 315 into the back mode 5, then another trick right before the drive tower, huge hillside edge. Oh, S5 getting a grab on there. Oh, then a bell, and then a Tweety Bird, that is the air Whirly Bird going inside the cable for a Rayleigh to blind. Way, way difficult place to do a trick. Never mind that particular trick. Then a backside 7, and he's still not done yet. Heelside 7, wow, that is not only a pleasure to watch, it's also difficult to commentate on. Dominic Gers throwing down an incredible run. Sanim, while he knows exactly what to do, he has got a lot to do having just watched that. And a first trick coming off the rail a little bit early isn't going to help him. So he has qualified in first. Sanim is a killer rider from Korea. Nice second hit on that second feature. There's the 90210. It is the Rayleigh with a frontside 360 oncoming inside the cable now at a corner number 3. Back mode 5, we saw that from Dominic straight into his next trick, then a 3135 as well. He knows he's got to pack in the tricks coming back round the corner for a big heelside cut inside, delaying that backside rotation till the very last minute on that roll to blind and a grab. There is the backside 7, and following up from that is the switch backside 5 from Sanim. Now he's got to sit tight, he knows he's got a second run. Those scores are going to be coming right through from the judges instantly, so every single one of the guys in that 8-man final will know exactly what they've got to do. Sebastian Zoloff off the top first, taking a fall off his very first trick in his first run. Can he improve? That is more like the rail riding we expect to see from Sebastian. Now we want some air tricks to back it up. 90210, the ready with the frontside 3. Coming round corner number 3 off his heel side edge. Back bow, super clean. This is much more like it from the Hungarian. Big air. Oh, I think he was going for the 3135, but just a 360. Huge as well. Look at the height he's getting on that KGB. The back roll with the backside 3. Then a backside 720. Solid landing. No touch in the water, not a waver. Then a heel side 7. Just about clinging onto it. Nice riding there from Sebastian, a definite improvement. Andreas Kjergaard, second off the dock, not having the best run. This is where he fell before. Coming off a little early, maybe a little bit wary now on that particular rail. 90210, not quite getting the full extension that I'm sure he can usually. This first run of his seems to knock the confidence out of him, but there is sort of the form that we expect from Andreas. Back mode 5, out. Then a 313 inside the cable, staying left foot forward. Looks like it's a toe side hit. Toe side. Chrome mode 5, getting a grab on as well. Just about getting away without putting his butt down. Then a front side 720, and just watching that handle disappear as he sinks into the water has got to be a little frustrating, but still an improvement from Andreas. Now, can Nick Davies do the same? These guys are all chasing Dominic Gers now, who is the man out in front. Backside rotation, adding an extra 90 degrees off the end of that. 270 on, coming off a little early on the inside of the rail. Now, outside the cable for a huge 313, getting a late grab on the end of that as well, staying on his heels for a Bel Air to blind. That is the tantrum without the wake, exactly as you come to expect of a cable. Then a 3135, both tricks staying outside the cable, staying outside the cable again. Oh, muscling around that chrome mob and seeing the appreciation of the crowd. And it's not surprising, after just about getting that is typical Davies style right there, popping a trick where no one else can, a toe side back roll, and then a chrome mob to round it off. So an improvement from Nick Davies, and Sanim now chasing that form that he found to get himself into the final. He came into this final as number 1. Can he come out of it as number 1? He is now reaching the halfway point off the back of that 90210. We've seen that same trick from a few riders in that position on the cable. Back mode 5, just about scrapes away with it, throwing that handle around and making that rotation happen so aggressively. Oh, then S mode 5 with a bit of a butt check. He's going to have to work hard if he's going to get this. Roll to blind with that Stalefish grab on. Not quite the clean grab, but getting the rotation happening and landing the trick. Backside 7, pops it round to left foot forward. Backside, switch backside 7 as well. So while a little bit of a butt check halfway through, I think that is an improvement. Will it be the difference between his second place at the moment and first? Det Clifford now on the box. Beautiful tail press to frontside 3 out. Toe side now across the cable. Scarecrow Moe. Very difficult maneuver indeed to try and get the height on that. 3135, nobody does it better. Some serious muscling of his maneuvers round. Deck is a big guy. It's so impressive to see him launching into the air as he does. Getting a little tickle on that KGB. Plenty of time. He's going to need to come back inside the cable to build momentum outside. Almost getting hooked up on that nose grab Moby Dick. Toe side now for a toe side backside what was going to be a 540 and a 7, and like Andreas, watching the handle disappear, and perhaps his chances of a podium. Sebastian Dunn now. We are impressed with this kid so far, making it to the final of his first ever World Cup, mixing it with the big boys, no problem whatsoever, not seeming fazed at all, killing it on the features. Can he do the same again on the obstacle, on the air trick, sorry? Big backmo 5, taking it nice and easy between corner number 3 and corner number 4, the drive tower, because he wants a nice solid 3-1-3-5. So easily done. There is no effort whatsoever involved in any of these maneuvers from the Australian. Roll to blind, comes inside the cable to go back out. Heelside 9-10, a heelside 10 from the youngster, Sebastian Dunn, absolutely slaying the course and going all out to find himself on the podium. Okay, now we move across to the man who is currently sitting off the podium, which isn't the place that you usually find. Freddie Van Osten looking comfortable on the obstacle so far. Huge heelside cut, head almost in the water. He's giving it so much aggression. KGB, then the 3-1-3-5. Has he got enough time for a trick before the corner? He's leaving it super late. Oh, does it just as the carrier turns. Now that is some serious confidence and some serious awareness of exactly what's going on above him. Another big technical maneuver and squeezing yet another big maneuver in right before the kicker. Can he get back outside? Yes, he can, on his heelside edge. It's a 540, not enough tension. His edge was all messed up after that inside trick. And he hands the baton over to this man, Dominic Gerz, who receives congratulations from all his fellow riders competing there in Beijing. What a run from him. First one off the dock, and he didn't need a second run. He is the champion here at the 40th ever World Cup.
Congratulations, Dominic. A tough final, but can you talk us through it?
Thank you. Yeah, it was one of the craziest finals whatever happened, and everyone killed it, and that's why I'm even more stoked to get the win. Everyone did like one of the best tricks you can do in wakeboarding, and yeah, to land the tricks in one run, it's just crazy. Wakeboarding goes to another level.
Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
So there's confirmation of those results. Dominic Gerz of Germany taking a confident win there with 85.33 points against his fellow German rider, Freddie Van Osten, on 76.67. Sebastian Dunn of Australia rounding out the top three with 73.33. So with the points and prizes awarded, tradition has it that the party should begin. In Beijing, though, there was one very special occasion yet to be witnessed. The day that Cable's founding father, Bruno Rixen, himself a lifelong skier, decided it was time to finally try out a wakeboard. Well, that's it for the 40th IWWF World Cup start. Join us again next time for all the action.